Hey, what's up, guys? David of davidglynrecording.com and theproaudiophiles.com. Today, I've got a couple of announcements. Super excited. I've launched a new site. It's at davidglynrecording.com. And to kick things off, I'm offering free pro session files. These are multi-tracks that you're going to be able to download and mix, pull into your DAW, work with the tracks, anything you want with it. Those are yours to have. These are yours to share, use for your resume, anything you want. Song is called Thread. It's by my good friend Harry Gettings. Beautiful song. It's pure, some serious emotions in this one. So I hope you enjoy that. And that's pretty much it for the site. So check those out. And actually, it's not it, because once you mix that song, if you send it to me, to David at davidglynrecording.com, I'm going to reply to your mix and I'm going to share another free download for you. So it's going to be another song, and it's going to have drums, bass, keys, guitars, vocals, stacks, all kinds of great stuff. So you get two free downloads, and only for visiting David at davidglynrecording.com. davidglynrecording.com is the site. And that's it. So we're moving on. I'm going to come into Pro Tools, and we're actually going to launch the files for this song. Here they are. You're going to get a lead vocal. I've got a reverb printed in the Ocean Way Studios and a piano. So I'm going to drag these in. You're going to see those three files right there. Now, I've got a template on screen. I'm just kind of prep this for you guys while I've got this going. You guys, if you haven't seen my vocal video, there's a lead vocal, the comp, and then the level. This is just the template that I use. I've got the Ocean Way. I'm going to put that underneath the piano. I'm going to get rid of that track. And what I want to show you, automation. I had a couple responses on the in the comments of some previous videos, and I had some emails actually about the same thing. Was, hey, great, thanks for showing me that you can automate conceptually the hook or whatever to make it bigger and all that good stuff. But how did you start that automation process? What keyboard shortcuts are you using? How are you getting through it so quickly? And I'm going to show you. So this can be done on any plugin. And now I'm in Pro Tools, so this is a Pro Tools specific trick, but I'm sure that the other DAWs are going to have something similar. So let's launch. Let's go to good old iZotope. Let's pull open an imager. And now we just drag these files in. The vocal is through a template chain I have, which usually most of those are going to be bypassed. But in this case, I've previously mixed this song, so don't be fooled. Those are actually the settings I used in my mix. But focusing in on the piano, this plugin just comes up. This is a factory preset, and there's nothing going on. It's just everything set to zero. This is a multi-band widener and imager, stereo imager. And let's say, let's come out here to some good stuff. I'm going to solo this piano, and let's listen to it for a second. Okay, cool. So it looks like that's the part he's just come out of. Let me see. Let's play from back here. Wash away, wash away. Memories, the world was slain. Get choked up listening to that one, man. When your buddy goes through something, you kind of get touched by it. So anyways, getting all emotional on you guys here. This piano is getting kind of energetic right there. So let's say I wanted to add some widening. Let's say we want to pull up that band a little bit, maybe make it a little brighter, give it some excitement. It's just this section. First thing I'm going to do is I like to bypass the effect because I only want it to apply to this section of the piano. Then what I'm going to do is I'm going to hold Control, Option, and Command on Mac, the three modifier keys, and I'm going to click on Bypass. You'll see that Enable Automation pops up. You want to hit that, let go of the modifier keys, and now that is going to be set so you can automate it. Here's the next step. Hold Control and Command on Mac, which would be what the Windows key, I believe, and Control on PC, and you're going to click it. And now if you see that track, snap to the automation lane for that specific plugin parameter. One more time. If you got this, you're going to pull it up. Let's make it a little bit larger so we can see it. Let's say that, let's come back here. The other thing is if you hit the, what is it, the dash or the minus button next to plus equals, you're going to snap back to your waveform or the previous view. There's a preference you can set for that. But the default is just to go between volume and your waveform. Let's say you're back here, it's your waveform again, and you want to pull that up. That parameter is automatable. That was our first step. And then now control, command, click. And there you go. All right, so now we have it set up to record the automation or to follow the automation, to read it. Let's add some automation. So we've got this track, this section right here. And right now the bypass is active across the whole track, which is why I bypassed it in the first place. So there it's all bypassed. And now it's only going to apply. I've turned the bypass off for that section. Let's hit play and let's take a listen from back here. And then we'll hear the track. Actually, let's pull this to say, let's undo that. Let's go on the one. Let's put it right there. And we'll pull it and we'll let it bang out right there. Okay, cool. Sorry, the OCD in me. Let's play from back here and let's listen to how it impacts the track. Adding some slight increase. We'll exaggerate it so we can really hear the difference. It's not really about adding the brightness and width to this specific song, but more the concept of the automation. So let's listen. Wash away, you wash away. Memories, the world was slain. I'm going to bypass it. Rolling gold and metal. Back in. Very cool. So it actually sounded pretty good with this song. So and I don't think that I did that whenever I mixed it. So maybe something to go back and look at. But anyways, DavidGlynRecording.com. Get your free download and try some automation whenever you get to these hooks. And then don't forget, send me your mix to David@DavidGlynRecording.com. I'm going to reply with another free download. And of course, don't forget to check out the proaudiofiles.com. There's been some really great articles, written articles on the site lately that I'm learning from every day. So I hope you guys are doing well, and we'll catch you on the next one.